我是伟力，
我是小欧。
周一到周五
4点到6点，
我们共同为您打造专属于新西兰华人的新闻风景线。
本节目由万国到家动动手指的线上超市
和万国旅行社冠名播出。
Look, vaccination is so important for all New Zealanders, for everyone in New Zealand. It'll keep us all safe. We know that we've got real momentum behind our vaccination campaign at the moment, but we really need to make sure that those people who haven't been vaccinated yet come forward to be vaccinated. So we're seeing some really, really encouraging, contributions. But this weekend's really about saying to all those people who haven't been vaccinated yet, now's the right time. Now's the time to come forward. It's really going to make a difference if you come forward and get vaccinated.
Okay.那奈斯要来帮我们做一下翻译吗？
对，我来简单做。其实部长呢就说，其实我们在一直以来我们的疫苗的接种率都是我们达到了我们理想的这个数字在一直，可是我们现在到了一个临界点，就是我们需要在这个礼拜六能够来达到我们最高可以达到的这个疫苗数字。所以对于我们来说，疫苗非常重要，我们抗疫也很重要，可是在这个礼拜六我们特殊的把一个聚光灯放在疫苗的这件事情上，希望大家能够来配合我们。
好，那其实我们目前看到啊，这个我们这次活动大概是一个有什么样的计划，或者是比如说在当天我们有一个注射的目标嘛？举例子啊，可能10万或者是15万剂。
Chris, do we have any targets for this Super Saturday? What are your goals that you're hoping to achieve? And what are some of the special activities that you've put out to make sure this Saturday is a success?
Look, there are a lot of exciting things that are going to be happening over the weekend to encourage people to come out and be vaccinated. Tomorrow morning, I'm heading down here in the Hutt Valley in the Wellington region. I'm heading down to launch the latest vaccine bus, Jabba the Hutt, which is going to be getting around the Hutt Valley to encourage people here in the Hutt Valley to be vaccinated. Later on in the day, I'll be at the Avalon TV studios where we're running the Vax-a-thon, which is basically about 8 or 9 hours of TV up and down the country, encouraging people to get out and be vaccinated and highlighting all of the fun things that are going to be happening. There are some really interesting and novel vaccine venues. For example, Air New Zealand have converted one of their big 787 planes into a vaccine location on the day. So people will be able to go and sit in business class to get their vaccination. And then they'll be able to head back down to economy class to wait out their 15-minute wait time where they'll be provided with some snacks. So there's a lot of fun stuff happening around the country just to get people coming forward to be vaccinated. But really the target for the day is just to get as many more first doses as we can. So we know that in Auckland, for example, we're sitting at about 87% of Aucklanders, or the eligible Aucklanders, have had their first dose of the vaccine. And we really need to get that up well over 90% in order to provide the best protection that we can. So we're going to see a lot of second doses in the next couple of days from people who have already had their first dose. And that's brilliant because it means they get up to the maximum level of protection from vaccination. But actually, we've got to get those first doses up. So we've got to get those people who haven't come forward yet to be vaccinated coming forward and getting their first dose.
其实在这个星期六我们会有很多很有意思的这个疫苗注射点，当然就是有不同的这个疫苗注射的公交车会有发生，就尤其部长自己是在惠灵顿附近的原因，所以他们有个叫 Jabba 这样子的一个公车。那当然我刚才听到最有意思的是这个纽航的波音78要成为我们的一个注射点了，哇，太厉害！所以等于说我们在 business 在商务舱里面，你可以得到您的这个注射，然后您到了这个经济舱的时候，就可以等待看是否有一些不良的反应，然后同时边等待还会边有人来送上小吃零食来等待，
哇，非常贴心的一个注射体验。
第二针了，
想再打一针哈。
是，那当然了，我们还会在其实这一次我们知道奥克兰现在第一针的第一剂是在87%的这样子的一个数字 87%。那其实我们现在希望能够在第一剂至少在奥克兰以及甚至整个纽西兰都能超越90%。来，重点是在超越这件事情上，对，我们希望能够比90%高。当然我们也知道说很多人在礼拜六因为有很多的好的福利啊等等的会打完他第二针，当然这个也是非常好的，因为这样子他们就有完整的免疫力了。所以其实这都 是我们喜而乐见的。当然我们在洋人电视台会有一个8个小时的这个叫 Vaxathon， 是电视直播，我们所有的政府的、
okay.
我们所有的部长们也会参与。可是今天我想在这边 先跟大家透露一下，我们华人也会有同样的活动，就是在咱们的 BNE 平台上面、所以这个也跟大家想要稍微的先透露一点点。Chris, I've just said we've got the Chinese version of the Vaxathon on this television on Saturday as well. So details to be announced very soon.
Brilliant. That's very good.
Okay, Minister, are you expecting Auckland for the first dose to reach 90% this weekend?
That's certainly the goal, but we don't want to stop when we get to 90%. So every percent you get above 90%, the effect is really significant. So one of the reasons that we want to get more people vaccinated is we know that COVID-19 is now out in the Auckland community and it is spreading in the Auckland community, and it will find the people who haven't been vaccinated, and therefore we'll end up likely with more people in hospital. And so now we've really got to say, if we want to keep people out of hospital, vaccination is now the best way of keeping people out of hospital. So we want to push up well above 90%. But we're seeing some really good numbers. So in our 65 plus age groups, we're seeing numbers as high as about 96% in some of those age brackets, which is really fantastic. So let's keep going. Let's keep making sure we're getting everyone vaccinated.
好，那还是你来翻译吧。
所以我们的目标当然不是停于90，我们的目标是要直接要超越90。因为随着现在奥克兰的案例越来越多的时候，刚才部长用了一个很恐怖的词，我心里咯噔了一下，是不是？就是，疫情会去，就病毒会去寻找到那些没有打疫苗的人。所以今天其实您打了疫苗，当然不是100%，可它会阻断传播，你也不会，您会更小的可能性得到这个疫情，而且更小的可能性进入到医院当中去。所以现在这是一个迫在眉睫的一个非常重要的一件事情。我们在普遍的就是整体纽西兰人口当中已经看到65岁以上的老人是注射率是96%了。所以其实这个才是我们现在想要达到的数字。当然我们也知道华人的这个老人是现在是非常低，在83%、84%这样子。所以其实我们是确实是有很大的一部分要去进步的。
是的。哦、
好，那其实啊，我们现在呢可能也会这个听到一些声音，或者是我们有听众或观众在反馈到说，政府会不会在稍后给出一些明确的时间指引，或者可能是疫苗注射率的一个比例的指引。举个例子，效仿澳洲的这个维州或者是新州，可能我们的疫苗注射率达到一个什么样程度之后，我们会适度开放到比如第二步，然后再到达一个高点的时候，我们可能适度会开放到我们的这个第三步，也就是 step three 的。那我们政府是否也会参考类似这样的一个行动呢？
也就是我们一直喊90%、90%，那到了90%，譬如说到了这个周末，如果真的奥克兰到了90%，当然我们讲全国要90%才行。那如果到了全国90%，譬如到了月底真的到了90%的时候，那会发生什么事情？因为根据我们的估算，大概也就月底月初的时候，如果照这个目前的注射率下去，应该到了90%。那个时候政府会公布一些日期或规定下来吗？
Minister, do we have a timeline in terms of we talked about getting over 90%. So for instance, if we hit 90%, what would be the government's next move in terms of regulations and in terms of our public health measures and in terms of obviously the alert levels as well? We've seen New South Wales give us a very clear three-step plan of what they want to achieve, the percentage of vaccination, and then what they'll do to ease the restrictions. Is the New Zealand government going to give us something similar?
Are we going to get some dates? Because it will be a kind of pressure for people to get vaccinated also.
So it's like we're giving them a deadline, I guess.
Yeah, look, next week the Prime Minister is going to set out a bit more detail about what life looks like in a fully vaccinated New Zealand. And it will be different to what we've had before. It will mean that every time we see a COVID-19 case, it doesn't become a big public health emergency where we end up having to lock the country down. We're going to have to learn to live with having COVID-19 cases, and our response is going to be a little bit different. So there'll still be protective measures in place to make sure that we try and slow the spread of COVID-19, but they won't be as comprehensive, if you like, as they've had to be, because they won't need to be as much in the future. We'll be able to be a bit more targeted. But the key thing for us at the moment is just making sure we're getting vaccination rates high in all parts of our community, because we can't have pockets of unvaccinated people being really vulnerable and exposed to COVID-19. So we know that we've got to get the vaccination rates as high as possible in our older age brackets, because they're the ones who are most susceptible. But then we've also just got to make sure that across the country, there aren't sort of communities who have very low vaccination rates, because we know that COVID-19 will find its way there and therefore it'll do a lot of damage. So the PM's going to set out a bit more next week about what the future is going to look like. But the best thing we can do in the meantime is just get those vaccination rates as high as we can.
所以总理下个礼拜，我们这也就是一个第二个透露，总理下个礼拜会跟大家来解释或者讲解我们整个，就是说在接下来的纽西兰，当我们的这个疫苗率能够达到，也是再次说是能高越高越好的情况下，我们会纽西兰会是什么样子，如何在跟一些病毒的案例共存的情况下，我们如何去再进一步的去等于说发展我们的生活。我们会大家看到说，因为现在有高的注射疫苗率的时候，我们不会因为一个案子突然一下要封城整个国家，或者说我们不会要用这么严峻的这样子的封城的手法去控制，当然还会有一些其他的这个公共医疗的措施，不可能没有，因为我们需要它去缓慢任何的这个病毒的这个传播，可是我们会看到不会用这么严重的手法了。当然了，其实我们同样，我们说一个，如果我们说一个国家的百分比的时候，同时我们还要注意两点，就是一个地理位置的一个散播均匀度和一个年龄层的散播均匀度。我们知道比如说我们的老人一旦得了新冠病毒的话，他们有可能重症甚至是死亡的率就比我们年轻人会高很多，他们是最容易得新冠的群体，所以我们要确保我们在老人65岁以上的我们的老年人群体是要能够达到一个非常高的一个疫苗率的。同时我们也知道在有一些比如说个别的村子或者在纽西兰我们叫或者小镇上面，有可能是疫苗率是非常非常低的。所以不管是因为什么原因，所以我们现在知道说疫苗这个病毒就是会找到这些没有打疫苗的这些小的地方。我们这次在怀卡托也看到了非常小的一个小镇。所以其实现在我们是需要是不仅就像我说的是人口的这个比例散播在整个纽西兰，同时也是在每个年龄层都要能够达到一个平均值。
好，那其实我们还有一个疑问是说，除了这次像我们有这样的一些宣传，然后或者是电视上面的一个长达8小时的这样的一个直播，或者是可能会有我们的部长啊或相关的工作人员会登上这个疫苗注射的巴士，然后鼓励更多的人，那针对比如说像你刚刚讲到，像奈斯刚刚讲到的这些小镇上他们的疫苗注射率比较低，或者在某一个范围之内那这个区域的相对接种率比较低的话，我们的政府有没有一些什么样的办法能够推高这个比例的人群，或者是有没有一些什么鼓励的措施能够让他们迈开脚步去接种呢？
Chris, you've just talked about with geographically there will be pockets in our country that have very low vaccination rates at this moment. What is the government actively doing to promote vaccinations in those places, those hard to reach communities? Are there incentives?Are there different types of advertisement? What are you or the government doing?
So that's a big part of what this weekend's all about. We're going to be out there in every part of the country, making sure that we're getting the message out, getting the word out about being vaccinated. So we know that some of those harder to reach parts of our country require us to go to them rather than waiting for them to go to us. So that's why the vaccine buses are really important, because we can get out there and we can take vaccinations to where people are. And that's going to make a big difference. We know that now that one of the big demographics that we've really got to target is our younger New Zealanders. We know that they're the ones with the lowest rates of vaccination at the moment. So we've got to do better at getting their vaccination rates up. So we will be taking vaccinations into schools, for example, and into the places where we know young people will be. So over the weekend, there'll be a whole heap of things happening. There'll be businesses that are offering free giveaways for people who come to be vaccinated. There'll be people giving away prizes. There'll be a whole lot of stuff happening over the weekend to really get those vaccine rates up.
Okay.
是的，所以其实部长更多答的是说，不是他们要迈开腿来找我们，而是我们要走入到社区当中去。所以不管是大家会看到的，比如说我们的这个疫苗公交车，还是说我们现在会把这个接种的地点送进到各种各样的学校当中去。所以其实我们是要在社区当中所在的这些地方，所以我们才需要这样子一个超级星期六，把所有人都吸引他们的眼球，然后知道说这一天要发生这么大的一件事儿，而且是一个浓缩的这样子一个大声的一个宣传。然后同时当然我们会看到各种各样的商家，他们都在推出他们不同的礼品，不同的奖励。我们也很谢谢我们很华社的很多的商家在配合着我们这一次的抽奖跟送奖的活动。
嗯，希望这样能够鼓励更多的人哈去来接种疫苗。
好的，那我们最后一个问题啊，
嗯，
也就是啊，我们说 Vaxathon 啊 Vaxathon 这个 only for this Saturday or there will be the next one in the following weeks。Minister?
Well, let's see how the one goes this weekend. Mm-hmm. It's a huge amount of energy that's going into this weekend's Vaxathon. We know that once people have had their first dose of vaccine, that it's easier for us to get in touch with them in order to get them coming forward for their second dose, which is why this weekend it's really, we really want to be focusing in on those people who haven't had their first dose yet. And then, you know, we'll look at doing other things if we need to get our second dose rates up. But this weekend's really all about getting up those big, as big a numbers as we can with first doses.
Okay.
所以我们就努力这个礼拜六第一剂最重要的，因为一旦我们抓到他们第一剂了，他们就会来打第二剂。所以我们要所有的人动员在这个礼拜六，大家一起加油。
好
好的，那我们预祝这个后天我们的这个 Super Saturday 啊顺利成功。
嗯，
好，谢谢 Nice。
Hope that it's going to be a great success. Thanks.
好，谢谢部长，谢谢。
Yeah,
thank
you so
much.
Minister.
Thank you.
Thank you.
我是伟力，
我是小欧。
周一到周五。
4点到6点，我们共同为您打造专属于新西兰华人的新闻风景线。本节目由万国到家动动手指的线上超市
和万国旅行社冠名播出。